Does the soil lab you often speak of test for lead? Judy?
No.
It does not.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely not. Mm-hmm. The UT Soil Test Lab checks for nutrients that plants need. And if you want to have an analysis done for lead, you'll need to go with one of the private labs around, like A&L Lab A&L. In Memphis, mm-hmm. and yeah, that's the one that's local that I'm aware of.
Yeah.
But there are other labs around that will specifically test for what you ask them to test for. It'll be more than $4 a sample. I would
yeah, yeah, typically lead, they use techniques that have really low detection limits because you're interested in lower levels of lead than you would be nutrients. And so there's a lot of higher costs that go into that, not only the equipment, but also to prevent cross-contamination because lead's so ubiquitous.
Yeah. Okay. Well, a few years ago, we did some gardens in the urban areas, and we checked the soil, and it was kind of surprising that most of the pHs of the soil was high, but it was because there's so much white gravel around, and you know, the limestone had raised the pH. But there was other analysis done in almost all of them because they were in old houses around, almost all of them had, you know, fairly high levels of lead.
Or
I say high levels of lead, just the presence of the paint, the lead paint.
It's not an endogenous.
It's parts per million, and, you know, parts per billion, and, you know, very low levels.